He was crowned king and given power and glory, so that people of every nation and race would serve him.
Welcome. Remember, this is God's world, so we are not alone. Wherever we are, whatever we may be doing, or what time it is, we gather as God's people, and we're glad you've taken the time to pray with us today. Please participate in this service as much as possible by joining in with the prayers and songs in this playlist. Let us pray.
God, we come before you, together with your saints in every age, trusting that your grace, mercy, and peace can make us whole and heal our broken world through the power of Jesus the Christ.
God, help us to follow in the service of Christ our King, whose kingdom has no end, for he reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, one glory.
Amen.
Remember, the Bible tells us ancient stories while also speaking to our lives right now. Let us listen to what God's Spirit is saying to us today.
Daniel writes his vision while in exile in Babylon. At a much later time, when the temple was desecrated, a writer wonders how God will save his chosen people from persecutions. A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. Thrones were set up while I was watching, and the eternal God took his place. His clothing and his hair were white as snow. His throne was a blazing fire with fiery wheels, and flames were dashing out from all around him. Countless thousands were standing there to serve him. The time of judgment began, and the books were open. As I continued to watch the vision that night, I saw what looked like a Son of Man coming with the clouds of heaven, and he was presented to the eternal God. He was crowned king and given power and glory so that all people of every nation and race would serve him. He will rule forever, and his kingdom is eternal, never to be destroyed. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Amen.
Jesus is on trial. The religious leaders could not name Jesus' crime. So Pilate asks Jesus if he is the leader of a revolutionary movement. This is the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Pilate then went back inside. He called Jesus over and asked, "Are you the king of the Jews?" Jesus answered, "Are you asking this on your own, or did someone tell you about me?" "You know I'm not a Jew," Pilate said. "Your own people and the chief priests brought you to me. What have you done?" Jesus answered, "My kingdom doesn't belong to this world. If it did, my followers would have fought to keep me from being handed over to the Jewish leaders. No, my kingdom doesn't belong to this world." "So you are a king," Pilate replied. "You are saying that I am a king," Jesus told him. "I was born into this world to tell about the truth. And everyone who belongs to the truth knows my voice." This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Pontius Pilate asks Jesus, "Are you the king of the Jews?" Jesus replies, "My kingdom is not from this world." Now, just to be clear, Jesus is not saying that his kingdom is up above the heavenly clouds. Jesus is saying that he is a different kind of king than the kings of this world, and God's kingdom is a different kind of kingdom than any on earth. So the question for us is, what does God's kingdom look like then? Certain countries claim to be Christian countries, even though they tend to worship money and profits rather than care for the poor, the widows, and the orphans as God commanded. Is that what God's kingdom looks like? The colonial superpowers of the past were so convinced that they had perfected God's kingdom on earth that they tried to export it to other parts of the globe, often through violence and genocide. Is that what God's kingdom looks like? And what about Belgium, this place we call home? Is this a good reflection of God's kingdom? We might have expected that the roads in God's kingdom would have had less potholes than Belgium. But on a more serious note, the reading that we just heard from the book of Daniel says, all peoples, nations, and languages should serve God. So not just the people on our side of the language border. And what about the other nations that are represented in our church? Is there any place on earth that has got God's kingdom right? I know for sure that Canada is not what God's kingdom will look like. It's just too cold. But what about other places like India or Ghana or Nigeria or Nederland, Indonesia, Pakistan, maybe England? Surely there must be somewhere that has perfected God's kingdom. Now you might be thinking, why is Stephen being so stupid? Jesus is clearly not talking about a literal country with a literal border. Jesus is talking about a kingdom without any borders. And you would be correct. And there is an organization that exists which crosses every language and culture and border, and it's called the church. Which is why some people say that the church is meant to be a foretaste of God's kingdom. And I wish that that were true. But sadly, there are many churches that preach prejudice rather than love. Or they commit abuse in the name of God. Or they are more concerned with membership and finances of their club than the sacrificial servanthood of Jesus. It breaks my heart, but the church has often failed to be the role model of what God's kingdom should look like. So, how then can we speak of Jesus as our King? He's already told us that his kingdom is not from this world, but how then can we be its citizens? Well, the key is in John's Gospel, where the word world is a bad translation. In the original language, it means cosmos or universe. So, for example, God so loved not the world, God so loved the cosmos that he sent his only begotten Son. And from today's reading, Jesus says, my kingdom is not from this cosmos. Or another way we could say that is, my kingdom is beyond this universe. And that changes everything. Being a citizen of God's kingdom isn't about one nation or one people or one culture or one language. We are already part of God's kingdom because we are part of this universe that God made and God loves. Second, it means that Jesus didn't just come to save me or you or us. Jesus came to save the entire universe. Every rock, tree, animal, fish, bird, but also every planet, every star, every black hole. That is how great God's love is. And finally, this means that Jesus is not only King of the Jews, and he isn't only King for the Christians. He is the King and ruler of the entire universe, every piece of matter and molecule. And in the book of Revelation, it says that Jesus is a king who is at this present moment, who was in the past, and who is to come. So for all eternity. Today, we are reminded that Christ's kingdom is out of this world. And for that, we can say, thanks be to God. Amen.
I'm not afraid to die.
Having heard God's word, let us now pray for the strength to live it in our daily lives.
As children of the kingdom, let us make our prayers to the eternal God. Let us pray. We pray for your kingdom to come in the worldwide communities of those who believe in Jesus Christ. May our lives enthrone him. Spirit of the living God, may your kingdom come. We pray for your kingdom to come in the nations of our world and in their leadership, for God's values to take root and grow, for each person to be respected as a beloved child of God. Spirit of the living God, may your kingdom come. We pray for your kingdom to come in our homes and families, our neighbourhoods and places of work, in all thinking, all speaking, and all action. Spirit of the living God, may your kingdom come. We pray for your kingdom to come in all hospitals, clinics and practices, and in every place of pain and sadness. Spirit of the living God, may your kingdom come. We pray for your kingdom to come in the final stages of earthly life, in the journey through death, and in the awakening to eternal life. Spirit of the living God, may your kingdom come. We thank you for making us and redeeming us, opening wide to us the gates of heaven. And now we remember the words Jesus taught us, praying together in whatever language we feel most comfortable. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, and deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, now and forever. Amen.
Peace be with you, and also with you.
Remember, in a moment this video will end. But our prayers do not. Just like God never stops loving us. Our service here may end, but we are sent out with a blessing in order to be of service to others.
May God, who kindled the fire of his love in the hearts of the saints, pour upon you the riches of his grace.
Amen.
May God give you joy in their fellowship and a share in their peace.
Amen.
May God strengthen you to follow them in the way of holiness and to come to the full radiance of glory.
Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.